Hello, welcome to my Disney Epic Mickey Rebrushed playthrough. This is something I've wanted to do for years, like even before this game was announced in February. This is probably my favourite game of all time, or one of the top 3 or 5. You've got like Mario Kart Wii and Minecraft there too, but this one is one that is very special to me, just because of my interest in art, animation, and just the old Disney catalogue. So, if that's one of your interests, I would very much recommend this game to you. So, we're gonna start a new game. I'm gonna attempt to do a 100% playthrough. I have played the game last week, and I'm midway through a thinner playthrough. But we're going to be doing a fresh one now, doing the paint path and then a thinner route later on. So to get started, we're actually going to go to the cinema. Wait, no, how do I actually do this in this game? The intro cutscene you can watch from the main menu in the original game, but I kind of skipped it to just go to the main menu here. So I'm going to just cut to us watching that because I need to actually get to it now. So I'll be back in a second. Oh, there we go.
A long time ago.
I'm not going to really speak too much over these cutscenes.
My mirror lured someone out of his bed.
I will comment sometimes on them though, like when it's quiet like this. This
opened a doorway to my workshop.
This intro and ending cutscene look amazing.
I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous.
Also, this game canonically starts March 25th. Or fully begins November 25th, I think, or is it 18? It's November 18.
Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project.
There he is.
I was putting the finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten.
There it is, his own creation version of Disneyland with a few tweaks. A version for forgotten characters he made. I remember when me and my mum saw this trailer in 2010.
I put the magic brush
down. Yeah, it would have been 10.
And retired to my chambers.
In a game store in Selfridges in Trafford Centre of all places, but I remember just going, wow, we've been there, and I was like, oh yeah. And then I got the game at Christmas. And it made my sister cry in this intro cutscene. Because she was like less than a year old at the time. So that's quite funny.
And thinner.
A few interesting things in this model that have been kept from the original. Well, they've remodeled them. Levels that just don't exist. They probably, I don't know, get destroyed from the events that are about to take place, but yeah, Mickey comes in, starts messing with tools he should not be messing with, makes himself because he's a complete narcissist, and you know what, just decides to have a bit of fun with it, because, yeah. And, I don't honestly know how that happened from just using paint, but, he uses the thinner to get rid of it, maybe a bit too much by chucking the entire jug at it nearly. Knocks the jug over, that's very important to keep note of. And then just ditches it, doesn't even attempt to fix anything. Yeah, bye-bye Disney World.
But I was too late.
So yeah, Mickey just destroyed
the
entire
was ravaged,
world.
A wasteland.
Grieved a Minecraft server, pretty much.
The mysterious intruder was gone. I did not learn his identity. Well, not for a very long time.
So it's implying, I'm pretty sure that Mickey does that before he even becomes a full star. I'm pretty sure because that's pretty funny that Mickey did the events of this game, or, well no, caused the events of this game, like, 90 years ago. Pretty funny. I'd be pretty shocked if this happened about 80 years after I'd done something too, to be honest, but yeah, he gets kidnapped. It's actually not the first time Mickey's gotten kidnapped, probably not the second time either. where was Yen Sid when any of this actually happened? Or was he just... I don't know. Was he in on it? This looks really good, this scene, by the way. Look at the shadow boss. Oh, the lighting, the sky. Everything looks so cool, man. And there we are. I like how this translates into pretty much... I think the game... kind of, like, with the graphics. Don't look at that. Right, now I actually have to start the game itself. So now we get the second intro cutscene. There's like nearly 8 minutes of intro cutscenes here, so I hope you were actually sat tight there, because no gameplay has actually happened yet. It's just that good. It is a bit annoying when games have cutscene intro cutscenes are like 10 minutes long, but if they're good, then it's fine. Mickey strapped to a table. And here's the mad doctor, a character that... And Oswald, don't forget Oswald. I love Oswald, he's my favourite. I think he is actually one of my favourite Disney characters, or characters in general now, after this game. Like, people probably say, oh yeah, really, Oswald, the character of, like, nothing nowadays. Like, no, it doesn't matter, shush. I just really like cartoon rabbits as well. This eye, honestly, I think looks creepier than it did in the original. So, the Mad Doctor is trying to, well, to a new player, trying to just kill Mickey here. But it'll be revealed why this is happening a bit later on. You're probably also wondering who the Mad Doctor is if you're not an Epic Mickey player or a Disney fan, and we'll explain that a bit more later too. Yes, because removing someone's heart and organs of a plunder is definitely the way the NHS intended. A lot of problems could have been solved with that. He didn't think to move that brush the entire time it was there. But then, turns out the brush clearly holds some sort of significance to say it scares off the shadow blot. And technically the Mad Doctor as well. But Oswald's still here with his brand new, completely white mouth. I can kind of turn into somebody. He still does his John Arbuckle scream. There it is. The John Arbuckle scream. You can have no idea what I'm on about with that, but I'm sure some people would understand it sounds similar. Missing sound effect one. Gus does like his intro scream when he does that, but it doesn't play here. Over here, Mickey. So I'm gonna attempt to narrate Mal's text boxes if I wasn't already in a conversation or sentence. I'm not talking to anybody aside from my camera. But I'm not doing voices now. One, you'll probably be able to tell from my voice for the foreseeable videos that I have a cold currently. So the reason I didn't actually record this last week was was because my sister got ill the day this game released. I was like, wow, what good timing. And then I got the illness, so it's like, I can't record. So I've only just got a blocked nose and slight blocked throat now. So you might be able to tell, but I'm doing fine now, so it doesn't matter. We're safe in this spot. This control panel can be damaged if you spin move. Use a spin move, pressing X here, I'm playing on controller. But I'm playing on Steam with a controller. I just prefer with a controller, honestly. Maybe it's because I played Epic Mickey 2 with a controller on Steam and Xbox, but with a mouse, everything just feels a bit more shaky. Probably because of my hand, but also the mouse. I like how smooth it feels when I use a controller. But yeah, spin this twice damages the robot, machine, animatronic. Mechanical Swiss Army Knife, that's what it's called in one of the concept art pieces. I got smart. Oh, I didn't there. So Gus is a 3D model now. he was in the original, but they never really used it at all, aside from near the beginning, after boss fights, and in the end of the game. He's always here now, which is really good. And text boxes will appear in the middle of the screen if they're not as important or just a slight hint. Also really cool. So, I did a video on this a couple of weeks ago on the game's demo, and it did exceedingly well. So, if you're watching or subscribed to my channel from that, thank you very, very much, because I gained a lot of subscribers from that. Well, not a lot, but quite a few. And like got nearly 4,000 views, depending on when I last checked. So one thing that people pointed out, that there was concept art here that I pointed out is missing in that video. No, it's just hidden here now, and I felt really stupid for missing that. So concept art has been moved. Chests are mostly in the same places. I say mostly because some have been swapped around, but I know where they are. So that is our first bronze pin. Well done, this is a collectible pin, one of many that you'll find in Wasteland. Most of them are unique and commemorate specific events or places. Sorry, I messed up. You should see how many you collect while you're here. Yes, you should also notice that you cannot 100% this game in one playthrough. You love when that happens. Though this game, it kind of makes sense. With there being morality systems in a way, kind of, not really. Because if you know, you know. Well, the Scrapper Mickey stuff. I mean, it's on Steam. Someone's probably going to make mods of this game before long, and I am here for it. So, let's go. This cutscene is fixed now. It's not audio delayed. I have to go home. I'm not doing that Mickey voice. That's the only line you're getting. The shadow blot. It's a thing made of paint and thinner. That blot seemed awfully scared with his brush. Wow. That's thinner. It dissolves anything painted. Gosh, I wonder what else this brush can do. That's paint. It restores things dissolved by thinner. You're quite the artist. Well, you're just full of surprises. Guess you just soaked up some of the blot. But I'm still me. Let's practice. Yeah, so because of Mickey coming into contact with the Shadow Blot on his way down into Wasteland and when he got kidnapped, there are now permanent ink drops that come off of him. So, the more in the game you paint, or the more you thinner, the less or more ink drops start coming off of Mickey, which is kind of part of the somewhat scrapped morality system. So we've learned to paint and thinner now and use the brush, so it's pretty self-explanatory from what you can see on screen. If there's like a highlighted thing, you can paint it in. I'm not going to read tutorial text boxes because I'm just going to explain it in my own words. But you can tap the buttons to splash it out, which could be more useful at times to do stuff like this. Or you can just put a stream of it and slowly do it in. Because splashing it uses more of it. As you can see from the left and right side of the screens. There it is. Yeah, you can see the thinner going down. I wasn't really looking at the door knobs, but it's the way of the accuracy and stuff. But yeah, you can use that much. It uses roughly the same amount, but it's just quicker. I do that. So with Gus standing here all the time now, one thing I mentioned in my demo video, but didn't actually... Oh, there he is. Hang on, we do this first. Cute little Oswald cutscene with his big chest. I love how he uses like his little fat stomach and rises it into his big pecs, I guess. But, so cute. This didn't change, I'm gonna be honest. While I adore this game and will praise it to no ends, I'm also going to fairly critique it, which I think is fair. Uh-oh. Sorry. Seers, part of the Blot's Blotwing army. Are they dangerous? Well, they're not good company. Get ready to fight. Use right stick to aim at your targets. Over friends, curses like this. Over opponents, it looks like this. You can fight Blotlings in two ways. Hit them with thinner to thin them out. Hit them with paint to turn them friendly. I've just realised the paint and thinner thing you can pick up with both of them are not in this game. Huh. Each time a opponent hits you, you lose a health pip. Lose all your health pips and you're done. Look at his face. Seers are only one type of bloodling. Other kinds are far away. That was too fast. You'll see soon enough. So Gus is standing here and you can speak to him for extra dialogue. The gears haven't been activated. They opened the gate leading out of here. We gremlins are responsible for keeping all of Wasteland up and running. How we do love to build things. Anyway, we were forgotten long ago, so you probably won't remember us, but every gremlin here knows who you are. The pips in the upper left show how much damage you can take. If you run out of help, okay, he's just explaining that. Careful, Mickey. So, I was told by someone that the dialogue Gus says here and in other parts is actually from the Japanese version of the game that released, well, after the game first released, and they added in and removed some things. Noticeably, quite a few things from the Japanese version are actually in this game. One of the cutscenes we'll get to later is the Japanese version. I'm like, oh, okay, I've never seen that before. But yeah, here's the first enemy, a seer. They called in a friend. Seers are kind of the enemy that got used the least in the original version of this game. They get used a little bit more now, which is good to see, but they're just eyes with legs. They're not my favourite, they're probably someone's favourite. But yeah, painting them in, they're now on your side. So in the original, there would be Mickey hearts. Mickey heads and hearts appear here, but it's just hearts now. It's not that big of a deal. This pipe in the original, if you played the original, you know that whenever a blotling came down, it was like when a cartoon neck swallows something, there's a giant lump going through it. There'd be a lump going through until it pops out, and it added more charm and character to it. It made you remember, oh yeah, this is a cartoon. But it doesn't anymore, so a bit of a shame. But as I said, if I critique anything, it's not because I hate this game or I'm angry at developers. It's just trying to point out something that changed and I'm confused why. One thing I'm glad they did change. When you get a collectible pin like this, it's actually visible in game rather than it being like a silver pin icon. So this is the first of many collectible unique pins we can get of, this is Dark Beauty Castle, because that's where we are right now. There are many of these to get in the game throughout our playthrough. Yeah. Also, our other first collectible you can get in the game, concept art. So a concept art is literally what it sounds like, but in this game you can now view them from the menu, which is really good. So there's the loading screen that plays whenever you launch the game. This is the courtyard, which is very, very good. Now this is, I'm going to mostly display these whenever we unlock them, because I think crediting artists and animation, people that do animation, is very important, because a lot of people that do that never get the credit they actually deserve. And all of this concept art is actually, like, is so good, it's fantastic, and it needs to be seen and praised. I don't want to say, like, I've got favourites, because I feel a bit rude saying that, but my favourite style of the concept artist is Jenny's style. Look at it more throughout the game. She's just got a style that feels more close to like how I draw, or well, no, just a style that I like more. Not saying that the others are bad, obviously, because they're all really good. It's just that's more of a me style. Because there's some that are more 3D modeled looking, there's more mechanical ones. It's like, wow, they're really cool to see how it looks, but yeah, I think Jenny's is my favourite, so. And wow, if she was watching this, hello, I love your art, thank you for working on this game. Thank you everybody for working on this game, because me and thousands of others, I'm assuming thousands, because this game actually has a really big fan base, and I'm glad that we're getting fed well. It was actually a miracle. So when this game got revealed, I wasn't even watching the Nintendo Direct Partner Show, okay, so one of my friends at the time messaged me saying, oh look, Poppy, there is a partner showcase. Am I stupid? Why can't I not? There's a partner showcase. Mickey doesn't scream when he falls now, but I'm pretty sure it's a shame. I was like, oh wow, a partner showcase. Yawn. So I was at McDonald's. I got a Happy Meal because I wanted to collect the Mr. Men toys from that they were doing in February. And I just look on Twitter while I'm eating, and then I see Epic Mickey Remake. I was like, you're taking the piss, right? I look on Twitter, not on YouTube, sorry, I'm like, oh my god, it's real. And I started losing it. I was like, no way, this is actually real. And so did hundreds of other people. So here's one of my first actual choices we can make. there is Gremlin Calvin. He'll be so happy to get out of that cage. He looks mad enough to break that catapult. When you see other gremlins, try to help them. They're sure to be friends. Or you could get a chest that's not really worth it at all. So saving Gremlin, there are like 30 gremlins, I'm pretty sure, in the game. They'll be in a cage every time. Thank you, Mickey. I feared the worst when the mad doctor put me on this thing. Mickey gets off this, by the way, before this happens. Because it'd be a bit bad if we stayed on that. Same with the gremlin. Now we won't endanger anyone else. Take this gold pin for freeing me. So yeah, there we go. That's this courtyard done. I think that's actually where I'm going to end this video, because we've already been recording 22 minutes, but that was... No, yeah, that's a fair enough video, so... I'm going to end this one here, and we'll continue into the next area through the projector screen in the next video, so... Yeah, if you enjoyed this, please do stick around. I'm going to attempt to try do daily uploads, or once every day, over a day or two. I have got uni work on top of this, and university itself, so... I only get Tuesdays to actually record when I've got free time, so they might not be up every single day, but they'll be going up mostly through October and should be done before the end of the month. So yeah, I hope you stick around, I hope you enjoyed this, I hope I'm not annoying and my voice isn't too stuffy, and yeah, that's going to be it for today's video, I guess, so I'll see you tomorrow. Bye bye!